Manya Srimati Bharati Amagaru Vedika Mundamunna Mahan Bavalu Mi Antariki Na Vandanamulu Samajamlo Undi Samajamlo Oka Sadasyaga Undi ఈ సమాజం కోసమే కృషి చేసిన ఈ మహానుభావుల్ని ఈరోజు ఇక్కడ అలంకృతం చేసిన దానికి సాక్షిగా మనం చూసినాం. ఈ సాక్షి గ్రూప్ వాళ్ళు చేసిన ఎక్సలెన్స్ అవార్డ్స్ ఇంత మంచి ఒక కార్యక్రమం చేసి దానికి పాల్గొనే దానికి నాకు చాలా సంతోషంగా ఉంది. ఈ అవార్డ్స్ పెరించిన వాళ్ళందరికీ నా శుభాకాంక్షలు. ఈ అవార్డ్స్ ఇచ్చిన దానికి ఏం అర్థమంటే వీళ్ళకి అవార్డ్స్ దొరికింది కానీ ఈ అవార్డ్స్ని చూసి ఇది ఒక స్ఫూర్తిగా ఉంటుంది సమాజంకి. దట్ ఈస్ ద మెయిన్ ఆబ్జెక్టివ్ ఆఫ్ ద హోల్ ఎక్సర్సైజ్. ఐఎమ్ ఆల్సో వెరీ హ్యాపీ దట్ దిస్ జ్యూరీ, ద గ్రాండ్ జ్యూరీ, ఐ వుడ్ క్లియర్లీ కంగ్రాచులేట్ ద మెంబర్స్ ఆఫ్ జ్యూరీ ఫర్ ద ఎక్సలెంట్ చాయిస్ దట్ ఐ మేడ్ ఆఫ్ ద అవార్డీస్. వన్ ఆఫ్ ద మోస్ట్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ ఆస్పెక్ట్స్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ సెలెక్షన్ ఆఫ్ అవార్డీస్ ఈస్ దట్ ద ఫోకస్ హ్యాస్ బీన్ ఆన్ హెల్త్ కేర్, ఎడ్యుకేషన్, సెల్ఫ్ డెవలప్మెంట్ అండ్ స్పోర్ట్స్. These, I think, are very critical today in our country. I am happy that we have chosen to focus on these very specific areas, particularly education and health care. Tamil lo manasakshi ante, it is conscience. Ikkada sakshi ante, it is witness. So today we have been witness to this excellent award function, and it has been done with a very clear conscience, and I would like to congratulate the Sakshi Media Group for organizing this wonderful function. Ladies and gentlemen, I thought I will also use this occasion to really talk from my Manasakshi, that is my conscience. Healthcare and education are very critical components of any population's happiness. I think the need of the hour is to focus on these two key sectors or segments, which I personally feel forms the core responsibility of any government. Both these areas, education and healthcare, must not only be available but also be affordable. So the availability and affordability of these two core sectors becomes extremely critical. And I think this is an area on which all our governments should focus. The other aspect that I would like to focus on is, today, somehow, there is a perception in society, maybe right, maybe wrong, that negativism is going on the increase. Why is it so? Do you think the media, which we call as a fourth estate, the fourth estate, I know, is a very popular program on your TV, Sakshi TV, which runs every night, and it is an extremely interesting program. I do watch the program regularly, I must confess. But today, from this stage, I want to speak as a fifth estate or the sixth estate. The fifth estate and the sixth estate have the right to differ from the fourth estate, and that is why I am taking the role of the fifth estate or the sixth estate today. I think it will be useful if the media promotes this positivism in a very big way in its both the print media and the electronic media. I am talking of this in a very general fashion. It is not relevant to any particular media at all. On a general this thing, I think citizens expect a lot of positivism to be generated from the media. Because, for example, in the morning when many people get up, they probably watch the SVBC channel or some other very good channel to sort of derive a certain amount of satisfaction and seek some blessings. And thereafter, when you sit with a cup of tea and open the media, maybe the print media or the electronic media, all that you see is sad news. Can we avoid the front page focusing only on sad news and sort of something more positive? And so also the headlines on the electronic media, can it focus more on positive, happy events that have happened in a country which has 1.3 billion people? I find it surprising that in a country of 1.3 billion people, all that we can talk about is probably a very unfortunate episode that a girl child has to undergo. Yes, this needs to be focused. This needs to be brought to limelight. But is it necessary to bring it on the front page? And is it necessary to repeat this hour after hour, half an hour after half an hour on every broadcast of yours? Are you brainwashing people into some negativism? And do you think people get the feeling that society has nothing but accepting these ills or these evils? And we talk of a harassment, dowry harassment, we talk of women's harassment, we talk of various things. And the other thing that I can't understand in society is every time there is an episode involving either a female child or an individual who is getting beaten up or thrashed, why is it that onlookers, instead of photographing, why don't they intervene and prevent it? I think it is time that society gets into this attitude of preventing such episodes rather than publicizing such episodes. All that we do is photograph it, video it, scene by scene. It is like, I remember on one episode where a person went to put a rope on his neck and hang. We were showing it episode by episode, saying he is now putting the rope around his neck, he is now tightening the noose, he is now getting ready to hang himself. I can't understand this philosophy. I'm sorry, I'm talking here not as a governor, but as I told you, I'm opening my Manasakshi today to before this Sakshi group of people, because I think you have a responsibility for society. Sir, you, the press, the media, the fourth estate is part and parcel of society. You are not different from society. You are a component and a very essential component of society. You must know that you are called the fourth estate because on you depends many of the formulations which a government can make. You can guide the policies which a government should formulate. I'm not saying that don't criticize. Please criticize. You must point out the shortcomings. Otherwise, I think we will all live in a world of oblivion and think that we are doing an excellent work. Criticism is an essential part of life. Change is necessary, and this change will come only by constructive criticism and not destructive criticism. I think we should avoid destructive criticism and look at constructive criticism. Let us say how a particular thing can be done. If there is a particular episode, if there is a train tragedy, what is the fun of going and asking that fellow, how do you feel? How does one feel when he's so badly hurt in an accident, sir? I cannot understand this question. Yatla undi miku, ikkada miku dorikinda, chikitsa dorikinda. What is this question, sir? What are you trying to tell us? But chikitsa dorukundi ante vaadu chachipoyaru chustunu untaru government. Why do you keep asking these questions? Meeku chikitsa dorukutunda, meeku mandu dorukutunda, meeku annam dorukutunda, fellow is being ravaged by floods. Why don't you as a media provide the relief there? Why don't you carry relief material and say this group is providing relief material to the flood affected victims? Instead of going and asking, ikkada evarna vachara mimmalni chusedaniki, ikkada manchineer dorukutunda, ikkada light unda, all negative questions. Why don't you focus, why don't you think that you as members of society have a corporate social responsibility? You have a social responsibility, forget about corporate. And that social responsibility is what I want the media to focus when there are such episodes, rather than asking such negative questions. Go the positive way. You are doing a great job by society, by criticizing. By criticism is must, because unless you criticize, we will not know what is happening in many far-flung areas, because your access is so total. But at the same time, please focus on some positivism. The other issue, or the other perception that pervades in society today is that truth has become a casualty. We do not understand the normal person. Many times people come and ask me this question, sir, what is truth and what is untruth? I do not know. I am in no position to find out, because one person says one thing, the other person says another thing, the third person says another thing. Why should we speak the untruth, sir? This is a nation which is known for Satyameva Jayate. A nation which is born on the criteria of Satyameva Jayate. Are we today giving it up? Just because you want to sensationalize something. Sensationalism is not required, sir. Your readership will go up, your viewership will go up, your TRP ratings will go up, everything will go up. If only you could focus on truth and bring out the reality on the ground. That is what people are looking to for a media, because you are the fourth estate. You are the guides. People look to you, sir, for truth. People look to you for a real presentation of what really is happening on the ground. Please do not distort truth. I know it's very inconvenient. Many people will say that, well, our media will not sell if it happens. But please, sir, let me tell you, after some time people will start reading you. Because in those days, I remember, the Hindu in Chennai, people wrote the Hindu in Chennai, and only after the Hindu says somebody has passed away, they will accept that the man has passed away. Because that fellow will put the obituary only after, probably after the 10th day ceremony is over, after confirming the man is dead. But here many times I think we kill a man even before he's dead. The man is already gone, because he has breathed his last, because he already written his obituary. You already written an obituary for a government. You have written an obituary for a person. You have written an obituary for various persons. And then you'll go about, say, breaking news. I told you that one day he will die. Sir, everybody comes with an expiry date, sir. You don't have to predict that somebody is going to die someday, sir. Everybody will die someday, sir. Then there's no use of saying breaking news. We predicted that he was going to die. So what is this prediction? We predicted that this government will go. We predicted this governor will go. What is this? The governor will go someday. But every day you don't have to keep on saying this again, then say, sir, we said it 10 years back, we said this governor will go. Sorry, sir, please let us get back to some code of ethics and some code of conduct in the media also. I know that you have a code of conduct, but let us follow it, sir. Because I think today you have a very, very, very critical role to play in society. Today, when society, when people are looking to you for speaking the truth, for constructive criticism, for useful debates, let us have debates in which people do their homework and come up with points, because people watch these debates because they want to understand what is happening. They are not watching debate as a shouting match. It's not a slanging match, it's not a shouting match that people look at too. People are looking at debates because they want to understand something. Many times I do say that, of course, thanks to my wonderful PRO, Krishnanand Garu, who does a lot of homework and prepares a speech for me, a wonderful speech for me. చదువుతామని అనుకుంటే మరి నా మనసాక్షి ఏదో ఇంకేదో చెప్పాలని ఉంటుంది, మళ్ళీ నేనేదో చెప్పేస్తాను. కానీ వాళ్ళు ఏం చేస్తారు, ఆ కృష్ణాన్ దగ్గర నుంచి ఆ కాపీ తీసుకొని ఆ కాపీని ప్రింట్ చేసేస్తారు. ఆఫ్ నథింగ్ ఆఫ్ వాట్ ఐ హ్యావ్ సెడ్ అండ్ దట్ విల్ కమ్ మెనీ టైమ్స్ ఇట్ కమ్స్ అండ్ ఐ రీడ్ ఇట్ ఐ లాఫ్ ఇట్ ఇట్ అండ్ సే అరే ఐ థాట్ ఐ నెవర్ సెడ్ ఎనీ ఆఫ్ దీస్ థింగ్స్ ఆఫ్ కోర్స్ మై పిఆర్ఓ ఫీల్స్ వెరీ హ్యాపీ కృష్ణాన్ ఫీల్స్ వెరీ హ్యాపీ దట్ ఇస్ ఎంటైర్ స్పీచ్ హెస్ బిన్ ప్రింటెడ్ బట్ దోస్ వెర్ డేస్ వెన్ ఐ రిమెంబర్ News reporters were all, they had to compulsorily have to clear shorthand, which means when they come for a meeting, they would take down shorthand notes. Thereafter, they would sit down, analyze the speech, and come out with the essentials of the speech. That used to be, then people would like to read, what did so-and-so say, and what is the import of it, what is the impact of it, what is the need for it. That is how press was. That's why the printed media is a very important component. The electronic media, again, is a very important component. Because hour after hour, if you keep seeing negative news, you get brainwashed with negativism. Sometimes even at night you think, oh, has there been this thing, has this episode happened? So please, sir, if you can avoid repeating negative news, say it once, that is enough. You don't have to tell us all 24 hours that this episode has happened to a female. Please, please don't say that, sir. Because you are giving ideas also. And one final request, very personal request, of course. Pardon me for saying that, madam. That can you look at some more happy serials on the TV instead of sob serials? Just as I told in the morning, when you get up for a cup of coffee, you would like to see some good news on the paper and not see a news of this accident or that murder or this is not available, that is not available, etc. So also before going to bed, you would like to sleep in a very happy frame of mind. Not that I watch the TV, I don't watch the TV at all at night. But I keep hearing sounds because my wife likes to watch these TVs. And I keep telling her every time, why do you see these soft serials? Some child is crying out of torture, or somebody is going debauchery, somebody is going with somebody else, the mother is ill-treating the daughter-in-law. Why, sir? Why do we have to show these things in TV? Are you promoting such ill will in society? Please, you have a responsibility towards society. You have a responsibility towards building happy families. You cannot keep on saying that every mother-in-law is very bad and every daughter-in-law hates her mother-in-law. I'm sure Bharati Garu is here, you can ask her. I mean, this whole concept that mother-in-law title ochindante chaddadi, daughter-in-law ochindante tortured. Vaddu sir idi. Please, let us have happy families. Let us provide happiness among the families. I'm sorry, I deviated completely from my task, and I want once again to congratulate the jury for choosing such excellent people. I mean, these are people who have given that today for our tomorrow. I mean, every one of them that you showed brought tears to my eyes. How did they do it out of their own efforts? That is strength. Please publicize such things. Show these things on the TV regularly. Keep printing these people. Let them be examples for society that these are people who can do such sacrifices. Look at the type of sacrifice that every person has made. Every one of them has sacrificed something. Mithila Raj has sacrificed her entire thing to learn cricket, and that is where she has reached today. Effort, determination, confidence, that is what comes. Hum honge kabiyab. That has been the slogan of all these people, and that is what you have shown here. I congratulate the Sakshi group for this excellent function, and I do hope and wish we will have many more such awards in the years ahead, and I would only wish them many happy returns of the day. Thank you very much.